Hello and welcome to our Being an Acting, Drama and Theatre Student webinar. My name is Marcus and I work for the Student Recruitment Team at Chichester University. And today I am joined by Bella, who is an acting student at Chichester. So straight into it, starting with researching universities. So what steps did you take before joining university?
So I went to quite a lot of open days. Just to get a feel for the campus and stuff like that. And I did quite an in-depth search on UCAS as well. UCAS has actually got a lot of information on it. And I kind of made like a bit of a checklist about what I wanted from a university. But I think visiting open days and going to as many universities as you can is a really good thing to do just to get a feel for them. Because you never know until you get there, really.
Yeah, definitely. And how did you feel about going to university?
I was quite excited, to be honest. I was just excited for a new adventure and stuff. There was always going to be nerves, just because I'd never lived on my own before. And having that independence can be scary and stuff. But I was mainly excited just to start a new chapter in my life.
Nice. And if you were to have one top tip for students deciding on universities, what would it be?
I mean, definitely go to the university, go to open days, ask as many questions as you can. There's not really a question that's too silly. This is a really big step that you're going to take. So if you've got any concerns or any questions about anything, just ask them. Ask the people that are there, or try and find some way to communicate with some people who are already there and stuff like that. But that's probably what I'd say.
100%. And we at the university do have quite a few other tips for students. So one of them that was briefly touched on then is visiting the university as much as possible. So every university will hold open days throughout the year that you can attend. They will also have campus tours and things like taster sessions and applicant days. So these are really good opportunities for students to go visit the university, get a feel for what it would be like to live there and to study there, and also to meet the lecturers. Another good tip is to test run that journey from university to home, especially if you're a student that is going to be wanting to go home at things like Christmas and Easter and reading weeks. You're going to want to make sure that journey is a feasible one for you to do. And along with that, you want to also visit the local area before you start university. If you're doing a full undergrad degree, that would be 3 years of your life. So you want to be living in an area where you know that you'll have enough to do, and an area that sort of suits you. And then Bella touched on this one as well, but our biggest one is to ask questions. So on things like these open days and campus tours, you will meet lecturers and you'll meet current students as well. So if you ask as many questions as possible, that is a really good opportunity for you to sort of squash any concerns that you might have before starting university. So getting started at university, what was your first week at university like?
It was quite normal to, I guess, a normal school week. I was in Monday to Friday, doing lots of induction weeks, induction lessons and stuff, and just getting to know my course mates, getting to know my flatmates. Went out quite a lot, just got to know loads of different people. So it was busy, but it was manageable. And it helped get a routine in place, and I think that was really important.
And did you find that you settled in quite well and quite quickly when you started?
Yeah, I think so. I think you have to just dive straight in. I think that was the mentality that I just wanted to fully submerse myself into the uni life. I think that really helped, and I got along with my flatmates really well. And we did a few dinners together in the first week, and did food shops together, and Like same with my course mates and stuff, you just have to put yourself out there. So it was good.
Nice. And if you were to compare your sort of typical week now compared to when you first started, how would your typical week look like?
It's a lot more independent now that I'm in third year. I think first year, you have a lot of hands-on contact time with the lecturers, which is really, really nice. But as you get into second year, and more particularly in third year, you get a little bit more independent with your studies, which is quite nice to have that freedom as well, and kind of the idea of like self-achievement too. Still like a Monday to Friday basis, definitely a lot more independent.
Cool, perfect. So in terms of your sort of biggest concerns before you come into university, did you have sort of one main concern?
Definitely living in like somewhere that wasn't my home, I'd say. Just trying to get used to a new room, get used to a new place to call home, I guess. That was my main concern, just feeling like safe and like relaxed in my home.
So touching on that again, how did you, I know you've just mentioned about how you felt about moving away from home. Did you know anyone that was joining the university or was already at the university?
No, I don't know anybody at Chichester, so I came in completely on my own. But we had a group chat set up before of our flat, so I got to speak to people a little bit before I came, so that ice was kind of broken already and I kind of knew everybody's names, and the same with my course as well. I had a course group chat, so I kind of got to talk to some people before coming, so it was a bit scary and a little bit daunting, but once you get over that first initial like, oh, I'm on my own, then it was completely fine.
Nice. And how did you feel about sort of the prospect of having to make new friends and meet new people?
I was quite excited, to be honest. I felt coming in on my own, I knew I didn't want to stay on my own. So having to make friends was a kind of I had to do it. So I kind of just threw myself at it. It was a nice feeling because everyone else is in the same boat as well. So you're not on your own, everyone else is trying to make friends as much as you're trying to make friends, so everybody's lovely to each other, and it's a really like nice community feel all around.
Nice, perfect. So in terms of, we're touching more onto the sort of academic aspect of the webinar now, what type of assessments do you have in your subject?
So it's mainly practical in the department. We do a lot of closed assessments, and we do a lot of opened assessments as well. You can do some assessments to some like public audiences and some paying audiences. But you also have to do some essays and a little bit of coursework as well. But it's definitely mainly practical, mainly group practical assessments as well. And then you have a few that are on your own too.
Cool. And how do you tend to prepare for those assessments?
Definitely being proactive about booking spaces and booking rooms and rehearsals and stuff like that. The department's really good with helping and guiding you with making sure spaces are available for you. And if you want to do any extra, I definitely say do some rehearsals in your spare time, just to make sure you're you know what you're doing and you're prepared. That's definitely what I'd say.
And do your assessments tend to be sort of at the end of semesters, or is it how many do you have in sort of general semester?
They're a bit more like spaced out throughout the year, so you don't just have loads all at one time. So you kind of, once a module comes to the end, is when you'll do the assessment for that module. Sometimes we have like assessment blocks, which are like three times throughout the year, where everybody in each year group and every course in the department is doing assessments. You can go and watch each other, so it's quite a nice like celebration of everybody's work. They're kind of spaced out throughout the year, so like every couple months or so.
Perfect. So in terms of starting university at Chichester University, we're very big on the support that we do offer to students. So as you can see on the screen, we've got a sort of long list of the supports that we offer for students. And in terms of the sort of academic skills, this is more based around the type of assessments that you'll have to do at university that you might not be sort of used to at college or school level. So at university, citations and referencing is something that students won't have a lot of experience with. So being able to book that one-to-one support with academic skill advisor, so you can sort of learn how to do that to make your assessments a lot easier. We're also very big on our sort of student health and wellbeing services that we offer, and that includes all of our mental health support as well. And then on top of that, we also are very good with our sort of disability and dyslexia service. So if a student discloses in their application that they have a disability, then the university will contact them and arrange if there's any extra support that's needed before they start. And if it is the case, they can even come and visit the university before they start to just get a general feel of the university. So coming on to the end of the webinar, in a few words, what would you say to someone considering studying an acting and theatre course?
I would say enjoy it. It's make sure it's something that you're gonna enjoy because you're gonna be doing it every day for the next 3 or so years. I definitely say make sure like it's the right place for you, and make sure you feel comfortable with everything, and make sure it feels like they want you rather than you trying to find like if they do want you or not. But yeah, I definitely just say like make sure you enjoy it, and just be open-minded to everything, and just go in all guns blazing, really.
Perfect. And finally, how would you sum up your time at university so far?
It's been a very quick journey. I'd say it's gone quite fast now that I'm in third year. But I've loved every second of it. I'm very happy with the decision that I made, and I love the course, I love the department. And I'm excited to see what happens next.
Perfect. Well, that is the end of our webinar today. So, thank you, Bella, for taking part in it. Thank you to anyone that's watching. And if you have any questions, please direct them to one of the emails on the screen there.